Hello, hello, how are you feeling, guys? You must be great, guys. Today we have a great video about the luxury cameras. Let's go for having this great video. Before going to the video, make sure to subscribe, channel, like, give an answer, comment, drop in how I can make better videos for you guys. Let's go! Okay, let's see what do we got. Alux.com. Alux.com is the, you know,
number 10, the Nikon D.
Nikon DS, DSLR, but Nikon. Oh, I thought 1 million, 10 million, sir, but it's $10,879. It looks, you know, so huge, you know. The another thing is okay, but it looks a little, so not a little, so much huge.
By Nikon.
Okay.
Sold for $10,879.
Well, this camera's look, at the it's low so end big, of the you know. The lens is it's a little, about. But the whole it's thing the is so big. I think it's more than 6K, 8K, and things like that. Oh, wow. Okay. It's looking.
Medium formats, this
and
is
another thing. Is this not so much, you know, heavy for the hand? If I have, you know, the camera guy to record film for me, it is not that much, you know, heavy for his hand. For example, if we want
the
to record more than 1 hour,
on the list,
and want to do some challenges, go on record vlogs.
It chimes in with 20 and a significant battery life.
Ooh,
what stands out about this unit
so
is its broad
big lens and this big lens. I think these are not that much cool for me. I think this is so much, you know, it's not heavy, and I don't like it that much.
The combination of sensor size
okay.
and resolution results in a flexibility only available in medium.
But another way
digital.
I like. Okay, number 9. I want to read the name. I'm really good in reading the name of travel actually. Okay, Mamiya Leaf Credo Medium Format Digital SLR by Mamiya, $12,950. This looks really luxury. I really like it actually. The lens is so big and it can, you know, record films so good.
The Mamiya Leaf Credo is a little different from other digital SLRs.
I think it's touch, you know,
in that it's manufactured in a box format.
If it's touch, I really like it. I really love it. And if I want to, in the future, buy a great, no, I'm not gonna buy it because we're going to have lots of camera guys, and we can, have this.
Mamiya offers 40
megapixels. It looks like the Lamborghini. Look, it's like this. You know what I mean? Yeah? It's like Lamborghini, and it's so big, and it's, you know, the Lamborghini of cameras.
Needless to say, 3,200 offering stunning.
It's so long, actually.
Lighting adaption.
I
also
didn't expect
tethered
this,
shooting
this
available
much
through USB 3.0.
Okay.
Number
okay.
8.
Okay. Number
420.
It looks very beautiful, actually, just because of the screen. Then the screen is, you know, have so much beautiful colors and bright colors. And you know that, and you know, I love the bright colors. And that is the reason I really love this camera. T420 thermal imaging infrared by Xtech, $14,846. Actually, okay, let's see. It's a little weird. I'm telling you, so much.
X-Tech. Sold for
$14,846. And it's so much different with the other
infrared cameras are just emerging.
Oh,
in the
you can do this, you know, do this, and this is gonna be on in your hand. Do this, and you know, get the camera and film. Okay.
SLRs, but are considered a.
Guys. I'm sorry that you couldn't, you know, hear my voice good because my microphone wasn't here, and I just forgot this. I'm sorry. And right now I'm trying to put it on. If I take this in here, my voice gonna record really better, really better. But I'm gonna take it here, and I don't have that much to, you know, hide this. No, I will. Okay, guys, I fixed it. I hope you hear my voice good. I hope. Okay.
Among the cameras du jour,
oh,
Yama
camera in the night. Okay, I love it. I love.
Military technology and are not
how they use military technology in this camera. And this is fantastic, I think. This is great. This is great. Okay.
Technology.
I don't like to
enhancing.
See anymore. I want to see number 7. What is number 7? lazier. Okay, the looking is very professional. I really mean the professional. Lazier 10803S type 006 MP digital SLR by Lisa. Anything, you know, anything is right, you know, you hear that from me. $16,995. Okay, let's go and see what it has. The looking in here is looking very good and amazing. I want to see another.
The Leica 10803.
No.
It's an outstanding camera.
I don't like it that much. No, it's looking. I am, you know, as of joking. It's looking good. It's looking good, and it's looking professional, not just a regular, actually just regular camera. It is really, really, really looking professional, and it has a place to you take your hand on it. And yeah, it's really, really professional. Actually, you don't. This is it. You don't need to use the hand. You use the hand when you want to take a picture, but when you want to record the video, you're gonna use the hand gimbal. Sorry, gimbal. Yes, the lenses, and I like it. Oh, number six. It's so big, huge. Phase 1 XF digital SLR 183 by Phase 1. $18,000. $18,054. Okay.
Digital SLR.
Let's see what you got. What you got?
Sold for $18,054.
Okay. This is I love the harmonic ones, the triangle. I don't like the, you know, the circle things. You know, circle shape. I like triangle shape. This is triangle shape, but I don't like it because it's looking like the old and so much old. I'm not meaning traditional. Traditionals are good. I mean so old camera. And old camera, I really don't like the old camera. So, but till here, I feel like if maybe when I continue, it's gonna be okay.
Of 100 megapixels, exceptional in quality.
190 pixels.
It is among cameras.
190 pixels.
This model includes.
Oh my God.
Image capture,
it doesn't looking. You know, the looking may be old, but the technology is so great.
Stacking and seismograph.
I think the new Xiaomi phone is about 100 megapixels.
But it's considered bulky.
Okay, I don't like it. I'm gonna.
If you're interested in knowing some more about their successful journey, you can check out our video.
What is it? Okay, number five. Leica S Digital SLR 2007 by Leica. $19,995. Like the previous one? It's not that Leica? Are you kidding me? I don't like. Right now, I'm saying I don't like that much the cameras. Okay, I'm really more comfortable when I record with phones. Okay.
Moving into
okay.
The top.
Because I don't like it, I'm gonna just skip. We've seen this. Come on, Alex. Come on. We didn't see these. No. T440 thermal imaging infrared by X-Tech. $20,000. I don't read another. So it's good to just know $20,000.
This camera is a sibling to the previous.
Come on.
Infrared camera.
Oh yeah, this is the previous. She's saying this is the previous one, and this is the new one.
It has a 320x24 other X-Tech, including onboard visual camera, touch screen,
and take it down. Touch screen, yeah, touch screen. She's saying my. Okay. It's looking a little huge. Actually, it's like. It's for Army, Hasselblad H3D3392 digital SLR, medium format by Hasselblad, about $21,000. I don't like it. I don't like it because it's like the Army ones. I don't like it. I want the camera was on the thumbnail.
To the fourth generation. Number two.
Number two. It's like a very great and amazing thing, but I don't like it. Okay, I don't like it. These are like you are, you know, carrying a big monitor. Monitor is not, must not be this much big. I know, I don't know nothing about the cameras. But you know, it's not looking good for, just look, I'm just saying good looking. I don't know anything about the camera. I just know I need to use them for making, you know, videos and content. And I don't know anything about them. So maybe that is the reason I don't like them. Come on, number one. I want number one. Number one. And it's so big. Come on, it's so big. The camera on the thumbnail was fake, and that was just clickbait. I was coming because of that. It just now it's just $38,000, and I don't want to read the name for you.
Here we have another sibling to the X-Tech cameras.
It's like the other, you can see everything in the night, in everything in the gamma, and things like that. Guys, thank you for watching till this end of the video. Bye!